Good afternoon, everybody. Welcome to Lillehammer 2016 and the Winter Youth Olympic Games. Today, we are at the Hamar Olympic Amphitheatre for two gold medals to be decided. The first is going to be in the ice dance, and the second a little later on today in the women's figure skating. We start, as I say, with the ice dance in this venue that was built for figure skating in short track at the 1994 Winter Olympic Games. It now plays host to the Storhamar ice hockey team, and also holds non-sporting events as well. In terms of geographical location, we are about an hour south of Lillehammer on the lake Mjøsa, just on the shores, and we are about 3 minutes away from the first group coming up for their warm-up. It's the busiest day of these Youth Olympic Games. There are 13 medals to be given away here on day four of competition, and we await to see the finish to this ice dance competition. The short dance was held on Sunday, and the couples have had a couple of days off to prepare and work themselves up for this free dance. You can just see the Italian pair there of Righi and Papetti, and in front of them the Estonian pair of Semenchuk and Gruzdev. But this is the start list for the ice dance free dance, and it is going to be the German pair that get us underway. The first four, the first group, finished between 9th and 12th. The second group, numbers 5 through to 8, are in the second group, and then 9 through till 12. Will be the final group, and they are the top four, the leaders after the short dance. Number 10 there, Anastasia Shiplevaya and Grigor Smirnov, but their lead over their compatriots Anastasia Skopotkova and Kira Aleshi is very small. It is less than 0.2, 0.18. if we are going to be precise. And in third place, it is the American pair of Chloe Lewis and Logan Bai, and they are some way behind, 2.7 points behind the Russian pair. The Canadians are back in fourth, but they are 4 points behind the Americans. So the free dance, if you're new to it, is a creative dance program blending dance steps and movements, expressing the character and rhythms of the dance music chosen by the couple. The program includes required elements that must be skated in time and phase with the music. And the couple should skate primarily in time to the rhythmic beat and not the melody alone. Choreography should clearly reflect the dance character, accents and nuances of the chosen dance music, demonstrating a close relationship between partners, with obvious distinct changes of mood and pace, with variations in speed and tempo. In terms of duration, as we see the warm-up groups coming up on screen, at around 4 minutes, give or take 10 seconds. The ice dance is the only discipline in figure skating where music is allowed to have words, lyrics. We're just waiting for the Zamboni to resurface the rink, and then they will have a 6 minute warm up. And in terms of required elements within the free dance, there must be lifts, spins, step sequences, synchronized twizzles, choreographic elements, choreographic spinning movement, choreographing twizzling movements. Well, all the events here are free for the public to come and watch. And to see that some of the youngsters in Hamar are taking advantage of that. In terms of the competition, the ice dance consists of the short dance, which I mentioned happened on Sunday, and the free dance. The short dance is the first segment, obviously consisting of a dance that's created by the couple, incorporating five required elements, including dance lifts and dance spins, to designated rhythms. Well, the designated rhythms for this season from the ISU, the governing body, is the Starlight Waltz, with described rhythms of waltz plus a foxtrot, march or polka. The free dance, as we mentioned, as we look at the judges, must contain combinations of new or known dance steps and movements, including seven required elements, which I've told you about, composed into a well-balanced whole unit, displaying excellent skating technique and personal creativity of the couple in concept, arrangement and expression. In terms of judging, the technical specialist identifies the elements the skater is performing in real time and the level of difficulty of the element, if applicable, and the judges focus entirely on scoring the quality of each element and the quality of the program's components. Judges' marks will be based on specific quality criteria for each element, and will provide a comprehensive assessment of each skater's skills and performance. The scores are added together, the short dance and the free dance, and the couple with the higher score will take home the gold medal. And Russia already have one gold from the figure skating, that was in the pairs. We also took the bronze. But there are the German pair that will get this free dance competition underway. 15-year-old Charisse Mattei on the now right of screen, and her partner is Maximilian Pfisterer. Mattei is 15, Pfisterer 18. And well, their score from the short dance was 39.29, and they currently sit a point above the Italians in 11th place. There are 12 couples taking part in this, and that is one of the two Ukrainian pairs, Maria Golubtsova and Kirill Belobrov. They are currently in ninth position. Opportunity here for the couples just to put some finishing touches to their routines. Germany, Estonia, Ukraine and Italy are all in this opening quartet in this first group. Youngest competitor in the ice dance is the Estonian girl, Victoria Semenchuk, 14 years of age. all about being able to deal with the moment. I'm trying to put into competition what I'm sure they do easily in practice. Coaches on the side. So we're about a minute away now from the competition getting underway. Scheduled to take about 2 hours. This will be the first couple that we will see. So the pairs make their way to the side and the competition is about to get underway. So it will be Max Visma and Charisse Mathai that get us underway. The Canadians are going to have to wait. Pairing kick off the third group.
Please welcome the first couple representing Germany, Charisse Mathai and Maximilian Visser.
So Mathai, 15 years old, Visser, 18, dancing to some music selection from Greece. 39.29 in the short dance. What will the free dance bring for this pair?
Slide.
So the first routine done and dusted for Charisse Mathai and Maximilian Pfisterer of Germany. Got their required elements in there. And we'll see how the judges score it. Some good moments in the routine. Couple of timing issues in parts, but not a bad start at all. There's their coach. There's such a loss up. Put the guards on their skates and they will await the score from the judges. Well, he seems to be happy with their routine. Into the scoring area they go. Let's have another look. This was the curve lift, the first of their technical elements. Nice timing. And that first bit a little bit out on that second spin sequence. The choreographic dance lift, the last of their required elements. So, what do the judges feel? Let's wait and see. .29.61 for the technical elements, .27.50 for the presentation. No deductions. .57.11, .96.40. That is the time, or the score, to beat. So, next onto the ice, it's the Estonian pair of Viktoria Semenchuk and Arthur Gruzdev. Semenchuk, 14 years of age. Gruzdev, 17, and they'll be dancing to a selection of music from the Scorpions. A little unsteady at the finish, but very high in tempo from the Estonian pair of Semenchuk and Gruzdev. Appreciated by the crowd as well. Some nice work in the routine on the straight line left and the rotational left. How will the judges score that one? Coach seems to like it. The straight line left, second of the quad elements, this the rotational left. The end of the combined spin sequence. A little messy at the change of music as well. Synchronized twizzles. So, how will the judges mark the Estonian pair? 96.4 to beat. They have an advantage of 0.77 over the German couple, and they go into first place, 31.33 and 27.21, so they don't get as high a mark in presentation as the German pair, but they have outscored them by 1.4 or there near enough, and they go into the lead. So next to skates for representing Ukraine, Maria Klubsova, 15 years of age, and Kirill Belobrov, also 15 years of age. Fifth at the Ukrainian Championships last year. They are going to be skating some music from Super Mario Brothers. Thank you. Just a little out on the timing. There were some nice aspects of the routine. But missed the finish with the music. We'll have to wait and see how the judges score that one. And here, Golubsova and Kirill Belobrov of Ukraine, the first of the two Ukrainian pairs, came into this free dance in ninth position. Their advantage over the Estonians at 1.31, but that finish, you just wonder how much that will cost them. Nice start, nice and light to the Super Mario Brothers. Just a little out on the timing. He opened up with synchronized twizzles. Some nice elements that were appreciated by the crowd. Spin, the fifth of the required elements. There's the change of music. Lovely spin sequence there. And the straight line left at the end, which was very nice as well, but it was just a little late. Now, technical and presentation scores to come. Maria Kultova, Kirill Belobrov, Ukraina, 35.23 and 31.06. No deductions, 66.29. It's 107.66. It's a huge lead for the Ukrainian pair. Good technical and presentation marks. So the last pair in this first group are the Italians Francesca Ricci and Pietro Papetti. They were second at the Italian National Championships last year, lying 12th after the short dance, 38.22, their score. They're dancing to the Umbrellas of Cherbourg. Perfect timing at the end from the Italian pair. All the technical elements seem to be in. Question is, can they make up the points deficit on the German pair to move up the leaderboard? The German pair scoring 57.11 for a total of 96.40. So the Italian pair need to be at 58.19. Above them. So they take their seats and we will get some highlights from the routine. Straight line left. Nicely out. Synchronicity. Those twizzles. Left. And a good finish from the Italian pair now. 58. Two thereabouts would be good for them. And 57.32. So they don't go up the leaderboard. 95.54. They do make up some points on the German pair. A better technical score, but the German pair had a better presentation score. And so that is where we are after the first group in the free dance. And it is the Ukrainian pair that have got the best score of 107.66, 66.29 in their free dance, and they've set the benchmark for this second group. They have a deficit, the Ukrainian pair, over the French pair, who are in eighth. Of 3.13, so a big ask. But this is the starting lineup for the second group. It's going to be the Ukrainian pair of Angelika Yurchenko, Volodymyr Belikov, and then Gutoz Domovachute and Davidas Kazala of Lithuania, then the French pair of Julia Vagre and Mathieu Courat, and the Belarusian pair Emilia Kelet-Anava and Odezulu Paluski. The eighth couple to skate. Interesting music selections in here. We go from Paganini, violinist for the Ukrainian pair, to Pink Floyd for the French pair. But it's tightly packed, this second group. The French and Lithuanian pair separated just by 0.08 of a point. And now the Russians just 0.12 behind the Ukrainians. So some close battles going on in this second group. But they're all looking to better 107.66 sets by our current leaders, the Ukrainian pair of Milia Klubsova and Kirill Veliborov. Finished second at the Ukrainian Championships in 2014, and that finished second in the French National Championships as well, going head to head in this group. See, just in this warm-up, there's an increase in pace from the four that went before. The aggression put into the routines. Of the warm-up, the male skaters in the ice dance, but 2 years more on those in the singles, and the singles is for skaters born between the 1st of January 1999 and the 31st of December 2000. And one for a 3 year window. Well, for the male skaters in the pair skating the ice dance, that's 1997. 1st of January 1997 to December 31st 2000. So the year at the youngest end. So the warm-up has ended, and it will be the Ukrainian pair of Angelika Yurchenko and Volodymyr Bilikov who will get this second group underway. Second in the Ukrainian Championships a couple of years ago. Yurchenko, 16 years of age. Bilikov 17, and they are dancing to Paganini, the Devil's violinist. And their score in the short dance, 48.00. Yeah, very nice. Very nice indeed. And you could just see there was just a lot more to it. More speed, more aggression. And a wonderful routine from Yurchenko and Bilikov.
From the Ukraine, Angelika Yurchenko, Volodymyr Bilikov.
Lovely work. You can just see the added elements of difficulty. The leg over the head of Bilikov on the straight line lift at the start, the first of their technical elements, and the curve lift as well was just a little bit more dynamic. Enjoyable routine. We've got some dramatic music. So let's have another look. Here's the straight line lift, and you can see, look, the leg over the top. Haven't seen that yet today. Using every inch of the ice. Through the leg, going into the twizzles. And here's this curve lift. Spin sequence. Judges say 107.66 our leading score. And well, they've been deducted a point, but they're still in front. So we move on to the Lithuanian pair. Zamavičiūtė and Davidas Kizala. She's 16, he is 18, and they are skating to Alice in Wonderland. Very nice routine from the Lithuanian pair. And their fans clearly enjoyed it.
From Lithuania,
and they look like they enjoy themselves as well, which is good. Dramatic music. I thought they did it justice. Judges. Let's have another look. Opened with synchronized twizzles. And again on the lifts there were these added elements as we see these opening twizzles. Straight line lift, but not content with just the lift, there's the flip over as well. Added piece to it. Spin element. Trying to chase down 114.6. Best scores in both technical and presentation have come from the Ukrainian pair before them. Let's see how they fare here. Taking their time. Here they come. .54 for the technical and 32.40. No deduction, 60.94, but they've dropped into third place. Behind Ukrainian pair that went third. So we go to the French pair, Julia Vagre and Mathieu Coira, 44.50 in the short dance. 17, he is 16, and they are dancing to the wall by Pink Floyd. Thank you.
Hey you, out there in the cold, getting lonely, getting old, can you feel me? Hey you, standing in the aisles and itching feet and faint smiles, can you feel me? Hey you, don't help them to bury the love.
Nice routine from the French pair. And a lovely rotational lift in it. And they will skate off to await their score. They're just one couple left to skate in this second group. Let's have another look at it. They started, or the first technical element was the straight line lift. Here it comes. And the synchronized twizzles. Connection between the two into the combination spin. Please up. Jordy didn't hold his end for too long, did he? But let's see what the judges think. Here are the scores. ...29.62 for technical, 32.52, one deduction, a total of 61.14, a total of 105.64, good enough for third. They go above the Lithuanian pair, who finished just above them in the short darts. He's not particularly happy. So the final couple in the second group, Emilia Kalhanova and Vladislav Palkowski of Belarus, 47.88, dancing to country music selection by Belziki. So was that good enough to go above our current leaders from Ukraine, who were just 0.12 in front of them after the short dance? Oh, the fans from Belarus will certainly be hoping so. Ukrainian score. Leader score anyway, 32.58, technical 35.38 for the presentation. Both the highest scores in the competition so far. Again, some very nice elements, although she doesn't look particularly happy. Let's have another look. Nice interpretation on the spin element as well. There is the spin element. Of line dancing in the routine. One of the lifts. So, what is the score? 114.6 is the overall score to beat. She looks a little nervous, she looks fairly relaxed. Continues. Here they come now. .72, 32.52, no deductions, 60.24, 108.12. So some way off the Ukrainian pair leading. But they stay in the same position they were coming in to the free dance. They're second overall at the moment, but there are four more to come. So these are the standings after the first eight couples, and it is Yurchenko and Bilikov of Ukraine that lead the way of 114.96, and it's the Belarusian pair of Karnava and Okulski, and then Golubtsova and Belobrov of Ukraine. That's your top three. We've got ourselves about a 10-15 minute break while the Zamboni resurfaces the ice, and then we have the warm-up for the third and final group where the medals in this ice dance competition will be decided. Don't go anywhere. We'll see you in about 10 or 15 minutes time for the culmination of the competition. Welcome back as the final four couples take to the ice in what will be the medal deciding skates. We have the two Russian pairs, but Anastasia Shipovaya and Grigory Smirnov, who are our leaders after the short dance, and Anastasia Skopkova. Alishin, who was second. Third place, Chloe Lewis and Logan Byer of the United States. And fourth place after the free dance, but getting us underway in this final group, it's Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Laga of Canada. So this will be a fascinating final four pairs. Russian pair separated by just 0.18 of a point. The American pair are some way off, 2.6 points off second place, but they are 4 points in front of the Canadian pair. So we shall wait to see if any of them can deliver a performance that will change the standings. As Marjorie Lajoie.
She is originally from the Ukraine, but now lives in Moscow.
Well. And her partner Zachary
Logan,
won the Canadian Championships. Passing to Don Quixote.
They come from Oregon and Colorado, but they train and live in Michigan. They are third after the short
term. Anastasia Shipovaya and Grigory Smirnov. Dancing to the Umbrellas of Cherbourg at the same piece of music that the Italian pair Francesca Righi and Pietro Papetti danced to. Months ago, and Chloe Lewis and Logan by the United States, 55.07 in the short dance, dancing to Tango Selection. Finally, Anastasia Skopkova, Alashin, Iko, Lugas, second at the Junior Grand Prix in Croatia, third at the Junior Grand Prix in Poland. Was a couple of months ago, but can they find the required score to go above their compatriots in the medal stand? So, business end this ice dance competition. Another couple. Pressure. Wins the Youth Olympic gold.
There is 1 minute left of your warm-up.
Mary Lewis. Russia, just the one goal in the Winter Youth Olympic Games so far. That was in the pairs. Earlier on, that finished on Monday. Couples.
Your warm-up has ended. Please
warm
leave
up
the ice.
Has finished. So we'll leave the ice. And the Canadian pair of Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Lagarde will take to the ice. She is 15 years of age, he is 16. 51.06 their score in the short dance. That's 3.06 better than our current leaders, Yachenko and Bilikov. Dancing to Don Quixote. Well, a performance full of energy. Is it good enough to take the lead away from Yurchenko and Bilikov?
From Canada, Marjorie Lajoyer, Zachary Lager.
And Zachary Lager. We need a score of 53.9. 63.9, excuse me, to move in front of our current leaders. We certainly need to leave everything out there on the rink. Let's have another look at some of the elements of their routine. Been the second of the technical elements required. Performance. Increase in speed towards the end, rotational lift, having the skate on the back of my partner. Finish, but is it good enough to take the score away? The Maple Leaf flying in the crowd. Go. And it is good enough. Look at that, 36.99 and 37.82. No deductions, 74.81. A total score of 125.87. And they move to the top of the leaderboard. Is it good enough for a medal? Well, they don't seem too overjoyed down on the bench. Right, here are our current leaders after the short dance. Anastasia Filipova and Grigory Smirnov. Third at the Junior Grand Prix in France a couple of months ago. 57.93 there. Leading score after the short dance. She's 16 years old. He is 18. Dancing to the Umbrellas of Cherbourg.
Plus tard.
What a performance, what a finish. The leaders after the short dance have surely won their medal hopes. No harm at all with that performance.
From the Russian Federation, Anastasia Shpilevaya, Grigory.
So, how the Russian Federation won their second gold medal here. The Hamar Olympic Amphitheatre. We shall wait and see. Some lovely moments in that routine. Score 70.83 to take the lead away from the Joyeen Lagar of Canada. Twizzles are excellent. And the connection between the two. Now let's see. They seem to have enjoyed it. Here they are. Get the feeling this could be quite high. 41.65 and 43.30. The one deduction that might just open up the door for the other Russian pair. But the new total to beat is 141.88. Now that 1 point deduction could be key. A lovely performance by Shpilovaya and Smirnov. So now it's Chloe Lewis and Logan Bai of the United States of America, third after the short dance with a score of 55.07. They will be dancing to a selection of tango music. She 15 years of age, he is 17, and they have got a big score to try and achieve here. Thank you. The penultimate pair to skate in this ice dance, free dance. Chloe Lewis and Logan Bye. Is it enough to get them a medal? 125.87 is the score to beat if they want to be absolutely sure of a medal with one to skate. 114.95 will see them into third place with one to skate. But well, they seem to have enjoyed it. What do the judges make of that routine? An interpretation of the tango music. Alashin make their way onto the ice, but let's have another look at Lewis and Bye's routine. Open with the synchronized twizzles. Element. Judges there on that previous shot looking on. Curve lift with the rotational lift as well. Go then. Technical scores 38.88 and 42.42. No deductions, 81.30, 136.37. They go into second place. They'll definitely getting a medal here at Lillehammer 2016. Presentation just 0.88 less than Plovaya and Smirnov. But now it's all about this pair, Anastasia Skopkova and Kirill Alashin of Russia. Second after the short dance program, 57.55. They trail their compatriots, the current leaders, by 0.18 of a point. Dancing to Eco Eco by Club de Belugas. Can they take the gold away from their compatriots?
My grandma, your grandma, sitting by the fire. My grandma told your grandma, almost set your tail on fire. Talk about it now. Jack, get out of my way. Jack, move, 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 jack,
Oh, dearie me. They missed the end. And have they lost the gold medal? There was a stumble just before the end. One of those things. Very unfortunate. It had been absolutely excellent up until that point. But within what, 15 seconds of the end, the error came, and there's a hush around this arena. Well, so unfortunate. Understandably, she's very upset. Probably done that move 100 times, 200 times. In training, and it's come off, but when it mattered most, the error. It had been superb until that point. Really good interpretation, good connectivity, fine spin, the twizzles have been superb. Midline step sequence though, with their undoing this, the combined spin. Change in the rhythm of the music. Rotational lift. There, and this is where it went wrong. She missed her footing there. Recovered ever so quickly. This was the choreographic spinning movement at the end. A real disappointment for the Russian pair. What has this done? 37.05, 41.82, two deductions, 76.87, 134.62. 2 still good enough for bronze. And well, they've got a medal. But well, the two deduction points have cost them the silver. Not good enough to take the gold away from their compatriots, even if they hadn't have fallen. And they'll still have themselves the medal, but it won't be the colour that they'd wanted or expected. And there are the results of the ice dance competition, and Russia take their second gold here at the Hamar Olympic Amphitheatre. The Americans through Chloe Lewis and Logan By second, Skopkova and Alashin, 134.62, the two deducted points. With the fall means they finish in third position. And Miki and Pateti, finish the short dance in 12th, finish the competition in 12th place as well. So the Russian Federation take their second gold here in the figure skating, and in fact the 2016 Winter Youth Olympic Games. To the end of our coverage of the ice dance competition. We've still got the ladies free skating competition to come, but it's Russia who celebrates with gold here in the ice dance. I hope you've enjoyed our coverage of this. So thank you very much for joining us. As I say, don't forget, the ladies figure skating competition concludes with the free skate. That's coming up at just before 3 o'clock local time, so in about an hour and 25 minutes. But for the time being, we will see you later. Bye-bye.
Hashtag #AWQ2050 #I love your diagram.